To the 2020 Tuffy Awards presented by the Student Life and Leadership Office.
Fresh out the box. Stop. Look and watch. Ready yet? Get set. It's all that.
Yo, yo, it's on, it's on.
Wait, I'm missing it.
Tuffy Awards, no, just start it. You're good. I love that we can just stay home.
Yeah, it's so nice. We don't have to dress up this year. Mm-hmm. We can just watch it from her couch. This is great.
Hi. Welcome to the 2021 Tuffy Awards. We got a great show for you guys tonight, filled with fun and games. We're gonna honor some outstanding Titans, so make sure you stay tuned for the whole show. And always remember, Titans reach higher.
Hi everyone, we'd like to take a moment to express our gratitude. Thank you to all of our nominators. We received over 150 submissions for 13 categories. With your support, we're able to recognize and celebrate all of the amazing individuals, organizations, and events that contribute to the Titan experience.
Hey Titans, my name is Xiao Pan. My pronouns are she, hers, and I am the sports club's coordinator in the Office of Student Life and Leadership. I just wanted to come on here and on behalf of the entire office, thank our amazing reviewers who took time out of their schedule to review all the nominations this year. Thank you so much. We had almost 40 staff across campus from all different departments review, and we just want to say thank you to each and every one of you. You know who you are, and thank you so much. Over to you, Christina.
We just want to take a moment and say thank you to our student organizations. Thank you all for putting on such amazing and engaging events, even in this virtual space. You all have brought life to this campus and this virtual environment, and we want you to know that we appreciate you and we are proud of you. So, from the Student Life and Leadership team, thank you.
Hello, Titan family, and welcome to the 2021 Tuffy Awards. You know, over the past 4 years, I've done a lot with Tuffy. I've rapped with Tuffy, I've danced with Tuffy, I've even been to Disneyland with Tuffy. I hang with Tuffy graduation scholars, I was at the grand opening of Tuffy's Basic Needs, and one time, even this happened. Look, the point is, I'm very close with Tuffy, and I do not let anyone or anything use the great power of his name and likeness unless they are worthy of Titan excellence and the excellence that Tuffy represents. You think I'm kidding? Titan alum and World Series champion, Justin Turner, he called me the other night and asked if he could create a line of Tuffy baseball bats. I told JT, win another ring and then we'll talk about it. I think you get the picture. So when I heard about the Tuffy Awards, the first thing I did was check the credentials of the winners to ensure their excellence is on par with Tuffy excellence. And I will only say this because Tuffy isn't here. But when I looked into what all of you, our student organizations, have been doing over the past year, I thought, not only do you rise to the level of Tuffy excellence, you exceed it. Case in point, as many of you know, when students first arrive on our campus as first year students, I ask just one thing of them. I say, jump in. More specifically, jump in head first, so that you become immersed in the vibrant student life activities proven to make your academic journey more successful and more fun. And to quote my message in your student handbook, if you've ever read that thing, the very first thing I ask of you in regard to this Titan lifestyle is join one of our more than 300 student organizations. And if you don't find one that you like, create it. By the looks of the achievement of this group and the many honorees of this program tonight, all of you are the literal embodiment of that ask. First, you created 24 new organizations this year in the middle of a pandemic, including the Afghan Student Association, the Asian American Journalists Association, Fullerton Skate, the National Association of Black Accountants, and Theater Arts Union for Student Equity and Diversity. And together, all 324 student organizations, you put together more than 1,500 virtual events, from game nights and movie nights to lip syncing and dance battles. And look, while I'm not thrilled that I wasn't invited to that dance battle, I'm proud of your resilience in pivoting on virtual. You kept the community engaged in the Titan experience with almost 3,500 students attending fall virtual, the fall virtual affair alone. And then your countless service hours, my goodness, putting you on the front lines of our community outreach in good and in challenging times. That makes all of you the backbone of transformative Titan experiences that we aim to create for all Titans. So, no matter what happens today, if you're part of this celebration, in my book, you've already won. You are already leading our university. You are already the students we point to when we say it takes a Titan. And most importantly, you are so very worthy of the Titan excellence associated with everyone's favorite pachyderm, everyone's favorite Titan, Tuffy. Thank you, congratulations, and have a great Tuffy Awards celebration.
Congratulations, everybody. You are the Titan family, and you are showing everybody in our community how to do it and how to do it really well. So hope you have a great time. We're so proud of each and every one of you. Have fun and congratulations.
And go Titans.
Wow, these student orgs are doing amazing things this year. So cool to see.
Yeah, I don't know how they're going to figure out who the winner is.
Seriously, it must have been really hard to be a reviewer. Crazy.
I wonder what they get.
What do they get?
I have no idea.
Tuffy Award winners will either be receiving a group certificate or an individual award with a blanket, pair of socks, stickers, and other SLL goodies to look forward to.
Wow, those blankets look so soft and warm.
I want one. I wonder where I get one.
Me too. They go perfect with like our work from home uniform too.
Yeah, for sure. I'm a big fan of blankets.
Hi viewers. We're giving away a blanket to 5 lucky winners on our Instagram for Tuffy Awards. So go to CSUF SLL and look for the Tuffy Awards giveaway post and tell us your favorite moment from the stream. Tag a friend and make sure that you're following us. And that's all you have to do for our chance to win a blanket. So with that, let's continue our program.
Oh, all right. Getting on social media to get in that giveaway. I want one of those.
Me too. I need another blanket.
It's no surprise that Titans are incredible, but it is important to remember that we are stronger together. Our campus is filled with folks who are always lending a hand and empowering others. And we would like to thank our student org advisors for being some of those people in our community. The Advisor of the Year Award recognizes a faculty or staff member who has supported and inspired a student org, as well as shown their commitment to diversity, equity, and inclusion. Here are the nominees. I am honored to announce that this year's Advisor of the Year is Dr. Edward L. Robinson, Jr. Unfortunately, we recently lost Dr. Robinson, but we would like to take this opportunity to present a special presentation created by the Black Student Union and Hip Hop Heads to commemorate Dr. Robinson and his contribution to Cal State Fullerton.
Hello, my name is Viviana Woolridge. So I've actually taken about 4 of Dr. Robinson's classes during my time at Cal State Fullerton. And one of my favorite memories is that he'd always play like a different song at the start of class, and he'd dance around and be singing along. And the main one that I remember is Sunflower by Post Malone. And he was talking about how he was going to play this song for his son when he adopts his son. And he would just always talk about all these different things that he would teach his son about the world, about what it is to be a man, to be a black man in America. And he was just such a great individual. And I miss him so much. But I'm really happy that he won the Best Advisor Award for like the Tuffy Awards.
Hi, my name is Ashley Landa, and I'm the president and founder of Hip Hop Heads. For everyone who doesn't know, Hip Hop Heads is a community of people who enjoy hip hop culture, and we provide a space to discuss real life issues that are discussed through music and culture. And I have been doing it for the past 4 years with my advisors, Dr. Natalie Graham and Dr. Edward Robinson. I first met Dr. Robinson when I decided to take an African American Studies class titled Black Political Thought. The class was an online class before online classes were a thing, and I was a little bit nervous about the structure, but Dr. Robinson made me and the rest of the class feel comfortable with the class's setting and made it known that this wasn't like our typical classes. We would be discussing real life issues that were happening in that time and are still happening today, and how they actually affected our lives and others' lives. We read real stories and wrote a lot in that class. And Dr. Robinson wasn't an easy grader. He made you work for it. So I decided to visit his office hours, and in that time spent with him, I got to know more about him. He would love to joke around, and I have to say his laughter was very contagious. In getting to know him, I asked him if he could serve as an advisor to my club after Dr. Graham informed me of her sabbatical, and he accepted. As an advisor, Dr. Robinson always kept me in track for deadlines, getting back to people, and ultimately reminded me of what it took to be a leader and all the things that came with it. I am one of the many lucky students who got to take his course, and I know that he leaves behind his legacy at Cal State Fullerton through his time in the AFAM department, his students, and his role as an advisor to Hip Hop Heads. Thank you.
Wow, I didn't have a chance to work with him, but
sounds like a really great guy.
Yeah,
for sure
will be missed.
Did you know that there are 60 competencies employers want college graduates to master before they graduate? The students featured on the screen completed the Emerging Leaders Certificate by earning a minimum of 6 leadership competencies or participating in the Emerging Leaders program this year.
Up next, we got the Titans in Action Award. You don't want to miss it.
This year, the Titans in Action Award recognizes an organization that has contributed positively to the Titan experience and to the campus community by exemplifying excellent social responsibility, civic engagement, community advocacy, and leadership skills, while demonstrating a commitment to diversity, equity, and inclusion. Here are the nominees for the 2021 Titans in Action Tuffy Award. Circle K International, College of Education Interclub Council, Student California Teachers Association, Student Speech Therapists and Audiologists Nurturing Cultural Enrichment, Students for Smiles, Theta Tau, and United Nations Association. And the 2021 Titans in Action Tuffy Award goes to Student Speech Therapist and Audiologist Nurturing Cultural Enrichment, also known as STANCE. STANCE is an organization that strives to foster multiculturalism and diversity within the field of speech-language pathology and audiology. Fundraising efforts held throughout this year allowed them to financially support national organizations with similar missions to theirs, such as the National Black Association of Speech, Language, and Hearing. They are also currently fundraising to help a scholarship that will assist student members with financial need. Through their programs and events, Stance has helped participants to critically think about their own personal biases that influence their worldview and identify how those biases may impact their future clinical practice. Great work and congratulations to Stance.
Everyone, I'm back with a quick announcement. Re-registration is now live, so I'm calling all of our current organizations, including our new organizations who just registered this spring semester. It is time to re-register your org. Re-registration is a three-step process. The first step includes filling out the TitanLink form on the TitanLink re-registration form on TitanLink. The second step is to complete the officer qualification trainings. This is for your president and for your treasurer. And the third step is to attend LeadCon. LeadCon will be virtual and it'll be from August 2nd to August 13th. Re-registration is open now until August 31st. If you want more details, go read our TitanLink news article called Re-Registering Your Organization for the 2021-2022 Academic Year. Go register your org.
Coming up next, a new award for 2021, the Outstanding Program in Member Development.
Hi, welcome back to the Ava and Emma Show.
Today we're here to announce the Outstanding Program in Member Development. Hey, Lisa, why don't you announce the nominees?
Sure, Emma. Let's get to those nominees. This year's nominees include Tuffy Hacks 2021, brought to you by Theta Tau. Woo-hoo! Professional Development Program by Pi Sigma Epsilon. New Member Installation by Circle K International. LinkedIn Event with One Sulting by Delta Sigma Pi. Woo-hoo! Giving Tuesday from Local to Global by Students for Smiles. And DKC and Public Relations Student Society of America for their internship program.
Good job. And the recipient is, drumroll please.
This year's 2021 Tuffy Award winner for Outstanding Program and Membership Development is awarded to DKC and Public Relations Student Society of America for their mentorship program. Woo! Congratulations.
These groups are really doing the most out here.
For real, they're doing all the things.
In a pandemic, too.
In a pandemic, I was literally about to say that. Good job, y'all.
Hello, everyone. I hope you're enjoying our program for Tuffy Awards. I'm Haley. I am the current social media intern for student life and leadership here at CSUF. And I hope that you are all engaging with us on our social medias at CSUF SLL. And if you are, please tag us at hashtag Tuffy Awards, TuffyAwards. And that's all for me. Hope to see y'all soon.
I'm going to go take my mask off.
All right.
Let me know if I miss anything.
Okay, for sure.
Hi, everyone. So today we're with the Tuffy Awards Planning Committee, and we are going to play some games in honor of Tuffy Awards. So we have Team Tuffy with Rihanna, Allie, and Glianne, and we have Team Titan with Ashley, Shalpan, and Christina. So the first team that's going up is Team Tuffy, and their guesser is Allie. So you have 90 seconds on the clock. And when I say go, we'll throw it to Rihanna and Glianne.
We got this.
You have 90 seconds. And the time starts now.
Blink and chill.
Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna say.
Yeah.
Okay.
The building our office is in.
TSU, Titan Student Union.
Our mascot.
Tuffy the Titan, right?
What kind of animal?
Elephant. Tuffy the elephant.
The street the TSU is on.
Like the main street or like the little itty bitty street? Okay, State College?
Yes.
Okay.
The slogan, oh gosh, we don't talk about Titans Reach Higher, it's the other one.
Oh, it takes a Titan.
Yes. Rihanna, what is
it? Alvin and the Chipmunks used it. Thing about it?
It's round.
For Christmas?
It's round and with a toy, and they put it around their hips, and they, like, move.
A hula hoop?
Yes. Oh, the area, all the tables on campus are where student orgs, like, table and cell fundraisers.
Oh, is it? Oh, there's a few of those. Titan Walk?
Yes.
Okay, I was thinking about it.
So we have the next team going. Team Titans, are you ready?
Let's go.
So okay. Ready.
So you remember, you have 90 seconds and you can act it out or provide descriptor words. Please do not use the words on the list. 3, 2, 1, go.
Sleepy, tired.
Yeah, but what do you do before? What do you do before? You're like, what's the action of it? Like, what am I doing? Yeah.
Okay. Notebook, writing down your schedule.
Like in the TSU, like what do students go to do?
Study.
Yeah. Ha 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 ha.
Funny laugh, joke.
Okay. We always complain that this thing is bad wherever we go. Like, hey, does anyone have any like blank? Like, do you have like the password for this? Like, the connection's not that great.
Have a stable connection. Yeah.
Wi-Fi.
Because you're blank.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. This one's like breakfast. An action.
And then it's yummy and you
toast it, flip it. Pancakes, flipping pancakes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay, I love so food, like, y'all.
this is like a saying at CSUF. They like God. So one of the ASI president, I think, used to say this. Yeah, we could skip that. This next one's easy.
Sleep.
Nah. Mm-hmm. Okay. We used to take Tuffy's friends here a lot, like walk around on campus, this big nature place.
Oh, the Arboretum.
Yeah.
A ring. Ring.
Yep.
Okay.
Glianne does Glianne this every weekend. This. Yeah. Every weekend in the water.
Oh, surfing.
Yeah. What semester are we in?
Okay, oh, so that's spring. End of the game.
I think you kind of felt like a second early. Right. Come on, I'm just kidding.
I heard the ding afterwards. But
we try. Just kidding.
Okay, so we're not going to count the last one because the bell went off before she answered.
I didn't even hear the bell.
Are you ready to see who Drum won? Roll. Drum roll, please, y'all. The winner is Team Titans by 1 point.
Woo!
Team Titans. You got 8. You were able to guess 8 of them, and Team Tuffy, sorry, you only guessed 7. Thanks for playing, everyone. Congratulations to Team Titans. We're going to continue with the rest of this.
Tuffy Awards Pro.
The following students achieved the blue path by completing at least 15 leadership competencies through the Student Leadership Institute. Amy, Perla and Brooke achieved the orange path by completing at least 30 competencies through the Student Leadership Institute. Congratulations.
Still to come, the graphics design competition winners. And don't forget to visit the Student Life Instagram page for your chance to win a blanket.
Yo, Glenn, did you remember to vote for the graphic and design competition?
Yeah, I did it last week.
All right, cool, perfect. I wonder who's going to win. I'm so excited to see. Moisturize.
Am I glowing like these student orgs?
You are moisturized. I love it.
I love it.
One is orange. One is yellow. No, I know. I know the apple's red on the out. It's yellow. Okay. Then, oh, we're live. We're live. Hi. Welcome back to the Tuffy Awards. Thank you so much for joining us today. I am joined by my amazing co-hosts, Reginald Bertram and Costco Wholesale.
Buy your hot dogs. Please.
Costco Wholesale has recently changed his name as a marketing stunt to get more money. Today, we are going to be announcing the award for virtual engagement for the semester, and it's going to go to none other than you know him, you love him, The Nice Club. So nice, so nice. With more about The Nice Club and what the acronym stands for, all we know is that they're nice. I'm going to hand it over to my friend Reginald for some reporting.
Thank you very much, Tim. This just in, thanks to this graphic provided by our incompetent intern, Daniel. As you can see, this this acronym is spelled out quite clearly to you all. So the N stands for nice, the I stands for nice, the C stands for nice, and the E, I'm so sorry, folks.
Does that say ice?
Yes, I, our terrible intern does not understand how to format images. This is beyond embarrassing. This, I am so sorry. But anyways, as you can see, or as you can imagine, thanks to Daniel, the acronym stands for NICE, each letter. Back to you, Jim.
You know, that's just Daniel for you. He doesn't know orange slices and he doesn't know how to crop. Well, thanks for the reporting, Reginald. I'd now like to pass it over to Costco, who will be reporting on the amazing things this club has accomplished this year.
Oh, this club, nice. Just like our chicken bakes and hot dogs at Costco. Costco Wholesales.
Okay, you're gonna have to cool it with the Costco plugs. Okay, Costco. Just
Jimbo.
Bring it down just a little bit.
Jimbo.
You're right. Your report.
Thank you. This club has done an amazing job staying virtually engaged with its members. Excellent email response time. Strong social media presence and excellent reviews from its club members. We wanted to film the club's virtual engagement practices to show you all, but they didn't allow filming, so we sent our very own sketch artists to depict the club in action.
Daniel, lower the camera. I told you, lower.
You seem to be a bit off of frame there, Reginald.
Anyways, I'm here on campus, as you can see.
Jimbo, okay,
no.
I love you, Jimbo, but you've ruined this entire story, okay? Nice Club does not stand for nice, it stands for not in contact, ever. They have been under a lawsuit for neglecting communication with their students. How?
That doesn't sound very nice.
Of course, they're in a lawsuit, that's what the story was supposed to be about, okay? The actual winner of the Tuffy Awards for Student Communication is the Student California Teachers Association, okay? State that. Student California Teachers Association. After the break, we'll announce the Collaborative Virtual Program of the Year.
The following students served as peer facilitators for the Women and Adult Reentry Center. The students featured on the screen participated in the Diversity Initiatives Resource Center leadership programs this year.
My name is Jordan, and welcome to the Tuffy Awards talk show. On my show, I like to spend some time recognizing the great work that our students at Cal State Fullerton have done throughout the school year. Today, we have two special guests joining us, Samuel and Isabella. Samuel, why don't you tell us more about the Collaborative Virtual Program of the Year at CSUF?
This award goes to an organization who's organized a virtual program in collaboration with at least one recognized club organization, department on campus, or community agency. The wonderful nominees are Arab Heritage Month, Community Service Interclub Council Spring Into Service 2021, Feed the Less Fortunate, Murder Mystery, a Virtual Halloween Party, Music Panel, TED Talk Tuesday, Tough It Out, and Tuffy Hacks 2021.
Thank you, Samuel. Isabella, could you share the winner with our audience today?
Yeah, I would love to. We are excited to announce that this year's winner of the Collaborative Virtual Program of the Year is the Community Service Interclub Council Spring Into Service event. The Community Service Interclub Council collaborated with a number of community service-based student organizations to provide students with information about how to get more involved in community service at Cal State Fullerton. Each organization hosted their own activities during the event, and Spring Into Service had a great turnout. The attendees had a chance to engage and interact with their peers.
Wow, thank you so much for that information and coming on my talk show today. Congratulations to the Community Service Interclub Council for this award.
Are you looking to get involved? Maybe with some of the incredible student organizations you've heard about today? Check out Student Life Connection. Student Life Connection is a tool designed to gather information from you as students in order to help us generate a list of personalized involvement opportunities that may interest you so that you can get the most out of your experience here at Cal State Fullerton. You can access Student Life Connection by visiting tinyurl.com/studentlifeconnect.
Hi everyone, it's your resident visual communications assistant here to announce the graphic and design competitions. So we receive a lot of nominations from our organizations. We receive logos, graphics, apparel, websites, and shared them on our Instagram. But if you haven't seen them yet, take a good look at our nominees for this year. Winner of the graphics and design competition for branding is the Chinese Study Society. And the winner for program design is Students for Smiles. Congratulations to these two organizations, and thank you to all the organizations that submitted a nomination.
the winners of this award will be receiving a blanket. Thank you to everyone who submitted a graphic for the competition, and congratulations again to the Chinese Studies Society and to Students for Smiles.
Up next, we'll see who the Emergent Organization of the Year is.
Hi, Mary. So thank you for sitting with us here today. As the outgoing Emerging Organization of the Year, SWANA, we want to take this time to get to know you a little bit more, a little bit more about SWANA as we get ready to present our new Emerging Org of the Year. So tell us about yourself and SWANA.
Perfect. Hi, everyone. My name is Mary Chalmas. I'm a third-year international business major, and I am the president of SWANA and the Lebanese Student Association. For SWANA, SWANA stands for Southwest Asian North African. It's basically a more inclusive and progressive term to use rather than using the term Middle Eastern. We're a cultural organization aimed to connect the community through our cultural events, through our SWANA umbrella orgs, and provide safe spaces for the community and club members to come together and debunk any stereotypes and myths and hold conversations about what is happening in the SWANA community. So the SWANA org consists of the Lebanese Student Association, the Afghan Student Association, the Armenian Student Association, Students for Justice in Palestine, the Iranian Student Association, the Muslim Student Association, and the Coptic Club, which all come together to make what is known as SWANA at Cal State Fullerton.
Wow. Thank you, Mary. That's a lot to be the president of, and we commend you for the great work you've done. As the outgoing org of the year, emerging org of the year, can you tell us what it's been like since receiving that award and what your years look like amidst a pandemic?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, ever since we received the award, we're super grateful. I mean, SWANA has done so much on campus and they still continue to do so much even during a pandemic. I'm super proud of my board, super proud of my team, and super proud of our members for pulling through everything. I'd say social media has been the number one pinpoint of connecting the community, connecting everyone together, doing outreaches to other orgs, you know, having people come together, not just within the SWANA community, but outside as well. So since then, we've been doing takeovers during the pandemic, or, you know, virtual Zoom game nights, virtual hosting like Social Justice Week workshops. We've been doing a lot online just to keep that momentum and that community together. That way, when we transition back in person, everyone's even more excited to come to our large and small scale events to celebrate SWANA and all the cultures and its heritage with everyone.
Yeah, great stuff. Great work. And we've seen you all continue to do great work and be a part, be really active in our student org community. So thank you all for what you do and even for coming back today, right, and presenting with us. We appreciate that. So as you know, I invited you here today to help me present the new Emerging Org of the Year. So drum roll, please.
The new Emerging Org of the Year is Theater Artists Union for Student Equity and Diversity. Congratulations.
Ooh. Congratulations. We are super excited for you, super proud of you. You're gonna do amazing. And while we have Mary here, our outgoing president of the Emerging Org of the Year, do you have any words of encouragement or advice for our new Emerging Org of the Year?
Honestly, keep doing what you're doing. I'm so proud of you all. I checked out your Instagram. You all are doing amazing. I can't wait for in-person events, and I might just come out and check out one of your Zoom meetings at your next one. So good job. Keep up the great work.
Congratulations again to the Emerging Organization of the Year, Theater Artists Union for Student Equity and Diversity. We are super excited to see all the great work you all will continue to do, and congratulations again. And now, on to our next award.
We would like to thank Adam, Gabby, Kyra, Alma, and Vivian for participating in the Service Leadership Program. Much gratitude to Amy and Brooke for serving as peer facilitators through the Student Leadership Institute this year.
This past year has pushed us to get creative in the ways that we connect with one another. Our campus has grown in the use of virtual platforms and taken creativity to new heights. The Virtual Program of the Year Award recognizes a virtual program produced by students and has had a positive impact on the campus community and beyond. The nominees for this category are as listed on the screen. Each of these programs have all made an impact on the Titan experience, and we are so proud of our students and organizations for their amazing accomplishments. With that, I am proud to announce the winner of this year's Virtual Program of the Year is Pilipinx American Student Association Kaibigan's 35th Annual Friendship Games. The 35th Annual Friendship Games hosted over 250 participants and featured special guests such as J.R. Aquino and Kolohe Kai. Their virtual program utilizes different platforms, which allowed them to stream their event internationally, gaining 10,000 views in two nights and allowing them to fundraise over $19,000 to support COVID-19 relief in the Philippines. Congrats to Patsakai Vegan on Virtual Program of the Year.
Welcome back to Wheel of Tuffy, everyone. I'm Haley, your host for tonight. Let's give a warm, warm welcome to our contestant, Jacob. All right, let's get our show on the road with our next topic, President of the Year. Okay, Jacob, your first clue is this person is the president of one of CSUF's cultural organizations.
Let me see. Is there an A?
You bitch, there are three A's. Let's see up on the board. All right. Looking good so far, Jacob. Your next clue is this person has started a disaster relief fund and has persistently advocated about how they took action through social media.
It sounds like someone I know. And I think they're the president of two clubs on campus. Are there any M's?
You are correct. There are three M's on the board. All right, you're doing really good so far, Jacob. Let's get your third clue for tonight. This person has also been elected as one of ASI's board of directors for the College of Business and Economics.
Ooh, that's a hard one. There's a lot of great ASI board members. Okay, Haley, is there a C on the board?
There is one C up on the board. All right, it looks like you're almost there, Jacob. Do you have any clue on who this might be?
I don't know, Haley. I think I might have an idea, but I'm not sure just yet.
That's all right, Jacob. You have one last and final clue to figure out who this person is. Your last clue is this person is the president of both SWANA and LSA.
Okay, that's what I was thinking. I'd like to go ahead and solve. Is it Mary Chamas?
You got it. This year's President of the Year award goes to Mary Chamas. Congratulations, Mary. Thank you for enhancing the Titan experience and for all that you do in advocating for both the SWANA and Lebanese community here at CSUF. Well, that looks like the end of Wheel of Tuffy for tonight. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you all soon. Bye, everyone.
After this game, the coveted Student Org of the Year Award and Titans leaving their legacies.
Hip-hop heads?
Dang.
Good. I was gonna guess music industry.
Club. Yeah, me too.
Me too.
Cause the head gave it away, y'all. The head gave it away. Accounting club.
Yeah.
The accounting society.
Oh, Ashley.
The goat. I want to say magic time. I know that's not the answer, but yeah, Harry Potter Club?
Animation. Not, that's not an animation.
Anyone want a hint?
Hit.
Magic Demon!
Yeah.
Leah, we've talked about them so many times. We should have known this. Music Industry Club.
You should use the crown one now because you're like amazing at this.
Students
for Life.
It's that new organization that's like Save the Earth or something from A.
Remember, these are some nominees for Tuffy Awards.
Symbiotic Earth? Is it that one?
No, it's like Save the Earth from A to Z.
Oh, yeah.
The
A-Z,
A-S-E-Z? Yeah.
Oh.
No?
I don't know the acronym. No, it's not them?
Nope.
I'm gonna go on my Instagram.
Around.
Is it Circle K International?
EdX, CSUF.
Dang, nice.
Good job.
Video game club. Gaming esports.
Yes.
Oh my god, this is embarrassing. This is so embarrassing. I'm so sorry, esports. I'm so sorry.
Mental mileage? Hilo? No?
I was literally the vice president of this organization.
It's okay, Allie.
Well, I was taking the word angels and minusing A. It was not working out for me.
That's what I was doing.
I just
thought
of the halo. Halo.
Hi, Dr. O. How are you doing?
Hi, Glenn. I'm doing well. It's been a good week, so I'm ready.
How's your new role as VPSA, Vice President of Student Affairs?
You know, I started in July during our virtual world. And, you know, I can say that it's been good. There's been some challenges, but I'm grateful that we're headed in a good direction with our health, and pretty soon we'll be able to hopefully be on campus again. And that's going to be nice to see everybody's faces, and we can like go to basketball again. Yes. We can eat lunch on campus. I think that's what I'm looking forward to. So I'm staying positive.
Yeah. I see that you filled out the Student Life Connection. Tell me why you filled it out.
I did. Well, I just felt like, you know, there's 350 plus student organizations on campus, and I feel like I've been disconnected a little bit from the student orgs, not knowing kind of like what they're up to and what the new ones are. There's like a ton of new student organizations, and all of our students are doing really good stuff. So, man, I'm hoping that you can help me to find one or two student orgs that I might like be interested in, so I could offer some support or just hang out, check out what they're doing.
Yeah, we can totally do that. Let's go through your form and see what you filled out.
Okay.
So we have your form up here, and as you see, there are a number of different categories that we can match you with. Where do you want to start?
So I'm thinking that maybe I've always been interested in community service. You know, I'm thinking working with maybe some kids, the cancer community, education settings. I have an aunt and uncle who are deaf, and so maybe people with speech or hearing needs, I think would be kind of cool. Do you have anything in that regard?
We have lots of those types of student organizations.
Okay.
I'll pull up a few just to get us started. So we have Titan Fawn, and they work with the Dance Marathon Miracle Network. We have our student speech therapist, audiologist, nurturing culture for enrichment. We also call them STANCE.
Nice.
Have you heard of Circle K? They're a pretty large international organization.
Yes, I was involved with Circle K when I was in high school. So yes.
Awesome. And then we also have the Leukemia and Lymphoma Club here at Cal State Fullerton. And then we also have Students for Smiles, who works with groups that have cleft palate needs. So do any of those sound interesting?
I think so. I could probably connect with a couple of those, but let's keep going.
All right. I know you talked about being interested in educational settings as you are the Vice President of Student Affairs. That makes sense.
Yes.
We have the Student California Teachers Association, and then we also have the Higher Education Leadership Organization, also known as HELO. We also have Abled Advocators. Have you heard of them?
You know, I have. I do like that. That's a good one. Tell me a little bit more.
They work very closely with our disability support services and anybody who might be interested in advocating for those with disabilities.
Nice. Okay, those are some pretty good ones. I like that. Let's keep it going. Tell me what else you got.
Are there any like hobbies, interests that you might be interested in?
Yeah, I like music. Big fan of music. Animation. Some maybe creative or some video games. I could go with that.
Yeah, we have a lot of those organizations as well. We have Women in Animation. They are specifically for women, but I know they collaborate with a number of other organizations like our Pencil Mileage Club, which is another very creative group on campus. You mentioned video games. We have gaming and esports, and some of those students in gaming and esports even compete in competitions off campus.
Whoa, okay. I could probably do some old school like Mario Kart and maybe some like baseball video game, but I don't know about anything else. So maybe keep telling me more. What else?
All right. Are there any like academic clubs or, you know, scholarly pursuits that you might be interested in?
Oh yeah. I'm a nerd. So if there's an opportunity to get connected with anything that's like academic or some groups that work with one of the colleges or something like that, that'd be pretty cool. I like history a lot too. So
we have a history student association.
What?
And I believe they're also a part of the bigger humanities and social sciences interclub council. Ooh. And nice. We have some engineering groups, you know, those who are part of the College of Engineering. We have an engineering fraternity called Theta Tau that is very active on campus. Prior to the pandemic, they were trying to coordinate a battle bots on campus.
Whoa. Okay. I would love to do a battle bot. Now sign me up for that. That sounds cool.
Yeah. What else are you interested in?
Let's see.
Any other majors or careers that you might pursue had you not gone into student affairs?
You know, yes, if I had not gone into student affairs, definitely would have done something with medical. My undergrad is in gerontology, and so I did a lot of my classes. It's a bachelor's in science, so definitely enjoyed the sciences. But you know, I also like going to Disneyland. So tourism sounds interesting. Something like music industry, that would have been a fun job. That would be cool.
We have all of that. So
yeah, what do you got?
We have a Latino Medical Student Association.
Oh, yeah.
They were actually our Tuffy Award winners last year. And then we also have a Physicians Assistants Coming Together group. Entertainment Tourism. We have an Entertainment Tourism Club, ETC. They do so many things with people in the industry, as well as our Music Industry Club. They're pretty active on campus.
Very cool. Nice. Okay.
Anything else that you would want us to know that... figure out other groups that might be of interest to you?
Well, I have thought about pursuing a real estate as a side hustle. You know,
really?
I've seen, I see all those home edit, you know, shows on Netflix and like redoing houses. That sounds kind of cool. Maybe when I retire, maybe that could be pretty cool. So
we have a real estate association as well.
Hey, that sounds pretty neat. Okay. There's some really good groups here that you've got, Glenn. Like these are some amazing student organizations. I didn't know we had that many. It's like, wow, that's a lot.
Just a few of our 300 plus student groups. But do you know what all of these groups have in common?
No.
They are all nominees for the 2021 Student Organization Tuffy Awards.
What? That's awesome. Those look like really good student orgs. Wow. I no wonder you recommended them. Thank you for only recommending like the top ones. That's like really legit. I like that.
Of course. Well, is there one that you think you might want to get started or learning more about?
I think so. I think I have one in mind.
Which one?
Well, let's do a drum roll. I say our Able Advocators.
Yay! Congratulations, ABLED Advocators. You are our 2021 Student Organization of the Year. That's so exciting.
I think without this club, Cal State Fullerton would not be the same, nor would the demographic of students be able to call Cal State Fullerton their home. So ABLED Advocators should be the Student Organization of the Year for these many years. And so congratulations to the ABLED Advocators, to all of the members, and to the leadership that put so much thought into not just your application, but also just making sure that everyone stayed connected this year and virtually. So congratulations.
All right, so welcome to Cooking with Student Life and Leadership. Today, I'll be showing you the ingredients to make a Titans leading their legacy. You'll need individuals that demonstrate several things, one of them being critical and creative thinking. You'll also need dynamic inclusivity and social responsibility. And you'll need someone who is committed to diversity, equality, and inclusion. That's really important. As well as making the road and the Titan community a better place. So this year's Titans Leading Their Legacy winners left a strong impact for current and future Titans. And because of their strong impact, we couldn't just choose one. So we have three awesome winners, and those three winners are Abel Marquez, Selena Mootball, and Gabriel Ponce. So congratulations for making the Titan community and the road just a better place. And we are so lucky to have you all. This year has been hard on everyone, but with students like the winners of the Titans Leading Their Legacy Award, we know that when life gives us lemons, we can make lemon bars.
Thank you for joining us for our 2021 Tuffy Awards program. We want to say thank you to our nominators, to our reviewers, to our student organizations, to our SLL staff, and everyone who made this possible. Congratulations again to our 2021 Tuffy Award winners. We hope that you all have a great rest of your evening and stay safe and healthy.
Ashley, did you save me any lemon bars?
Mm,
what?
No.